Hey everybody, it's your personal trainer, Coach Kozak.
And I'm Claudia, and this is a HIIT workout for fat loss and strength.
The only equipment required for this workout is a pair of dumbbells.
And the weight that you're going to use is going to be completely dependent upon your fitness level.
I'm going to be doing the intermediate through advanced exercises.
And follow me for those beginner modifications.
All right, if you're ready to go, Claudia, ready?
I'm ready to do this.
Okay, we're going to get started with a nice little warm-up. So the purpose of this warm-up is just to get your heart rate up. It's not to burn you out. We're going to do an arm crossover plus butt kick to start.
AKA don't go crazy with this butt kick crossover movement.
Exactly. This is just to get you loosened up. We got plenty of actual workout coming up. So we're going stepping side to side, bringing that heel back, kicking, trying to kick our glutes. And as we're crossing our arms over, I'd like you to alternate which arm is on top. Now for this one, as well as all the other ones for the rest of the day, we're not counting any repetitions. So we're just trying to complete as many reps as possible in the allotted time period. And we're breathing. Let's continue this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Next, we're gonna do a standing elbow to knee. So feet are shoulder width apart, hands are on our head. We're gonna go opposite elbow to opposite knee. Now, if you can't quite bring your knee up as far as we are, that's okay. Just do the best you can. Make sure to bring that knee up and in at the same time. So we're squeezing those abs, loosening up our hips, our core, a little bit of shoulders in there. Breathing again, moving at a warm-up pace, not a work pace. Let's do this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. All right. We're gonna do an arm pullover, last one in the warm-up round, feet shoulder width apart, back is bent on a 45-degree angle, arms are straight. We're gonna pull those arms up and over, and then let them swing back the opposite way with your palm up. Trying to get full range of motion on this one, being sure to breathe.
Warming up that back, those arms, feeling that my shoulders are ready. Because I need to slow it down a bit.
Loosen it up. Get that heart rate up a little bit. Let's hit this one for just 5 more seconds, everybody. And 3, 2, 1, 0. Good. Okay, so we are going to need your dumbbells for the first exercise. Both of them. And Claudia and I are going to be doing a different variation throughout the course of today's workout. You're going to need to decide if it's better for you to do my variations or Claudia's modifiers.
Or a combo of the two.
Or, yeah, combination of the two. Feet are shoulder width apart. Little bend in the knees. We're going to do a dumbbell clean, dumbbell swing back, and then forward and up. Now, I'm going to drop into a reverse lunge.
And I'm going to drop into a front squat.
Both of us are putting our weight back on our hips, using those hips to drive forward and clean those dumbbells up. And Claudia is just gonna hit that front squat, so she's on both legs equally, where my variation is gonna put the majority of your body weight on that front leg.
And with the front squat, of course, I'm breaking at the hips, pushing my booty back into a squat and keeping my knees out. Do not let your knees collapse in.
On this reverse lunge, I'm dropping that back knee till it gets to a 90-degree angle, alternating back and forth, right leg, then left leg. Good. Let's keep this one up for 10 more seconds, guys. Stick with it. Breathe. We're going to focus on that breathing today for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All right, so we just need one dumbbell for the next one. We're gonna go to the ground and do a push-up position. Claudia's gonna be on her knees. I'm gonna be up top. We're gonna go push up. And then as we come up, we're gonna row, pull the elbow in, twist, and press. You decide if it's better for you to be down on your knees or up top.
And on the twist, you see I'm bringing my right knee up over my left one. So it's down, pull it into a row, and turn to the right with my right knee on top and back down.
We're both keeping our core nice and straight and tight. Back stays nice and straight. You don't want that butt way up in the air. And we're gonna get equal time on both sides. Not excellent. Core stays tight throughout. Let's hit this one on this side for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and switch. All right, other side. I know this is a good one. All these movements today you're gonna notice are hitting multiple muscle groups at the same time. So this one's hitting your core, lower back, triceps, shoulders, chest. I don't know, I might even be missing something.
That's okay, your body will tell you tomorrow.
Right? You guys are doing great, keep it up. Keep that elbow in on both the row and that twist. Press straight up and back down. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We're up on our feet for the next one. Still need the one dumbbell. We're gonna do a side lunge or a side squat plus an upright row. I'm gonna take a big step where Claudia's gonna take a shorter step, and then we're both dropping back with the weight in our hips. And as we come up, we're bringing that elbow nice and high. Pulling up from the elbow, being sure to breathe throughout. We're gonna get equal time on both legs. Good. If you're doing this side lunge, try your best to keep that inside leg nice and straight. We're both keeping our core tight, back straight. Good.
Head up, chest up on the squat.
Let's switch this one in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Opposite side, right into it. Let's go. Good. So basically, the bigger the step you take, the more of a challenge this one is gonna be. You decide which variation's right for you along the way.
Whew.
A lot of unilateral moves we're gonna do today, which is basically working each side of the body separately from one another. Great technique to do to make sure you don't have any imbalances. And if you do, it'll help to work them out. Excellent. So it's working your hamstrings, your glutes, your quads, your core, your traps, shoulders. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. To the ground we're gonna go, one dumbbell still. We're gonna get up into a high plank position. I'm gonna do a bear plank, Claudia's gonna be on her knees. We're both gonna row, pull back from the elbow, renegade row, and then knee up and in. You decide if you're gonna do it from your knees or in this bear plank position. Either way, you're keeping your back straight, core tight, pull back from that elbow on your row.
Remembering to breathe through the movement.
Definitely.
Do not hold your breath.
Anytime we get up in this plank position, really gotta focus on your breathing. It's easy to hold that breath. Good. If you're doing this bear plank, trying to keep both knees bent at a 90 degree angle. Let's hit this one in this side for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Opposite side, switch it up and right into it, guys. Just everything's opposite. Opposite arm pulls and knee up and in. Excellent work. Throughout the course of today's workout, you are gonna be challenged. You are gonna have times where you're thinking about, why am I here right now? So it's important that you focus on what motivates you, what drives you, what brought you here today to begin with, because that is what's gonna be the thing that gets you through to the end. Come on, keep it up. Let's hit this one for 5 more seconds. Almost there, guys. 3, 2, 1, 0. Good, we need both dumbbells for the next one. We're doing a 1.5 sumo deadlift. Legs are nice and wide, toes are pointed out, dumbbells are in front. Weight back on our hips, break at the knees. Up, and then halfway up and back down. We're going 1.5, I'm gonna jump. Claudia's just gonna do the 1.5. So all the way down, halfway up, back down, and repeat.
Go ahead, sorry.
I was gonna say, you decide if that jump is right for you.
Keep your head up, chest up, and drop that weight back into your hips. Come right back up and squeeze your glutes right at the top.
This one is all about that backside. So making sure you're getting your weight back there on every rep. Good. Let's keep this one up for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Good. Okay, we need your dumbbells for the next one. We're going to the ground, lying down on our backs. Claudia's gonna have her feet up. I'm gonna have my legs straight. We're gonna do a press to elbow. So we're gonna press up on that opposite elbow to make this exercise harder. You can do an isometric leg raise. We just hold those legs out straight in front of you. And you decide which variation is right for you. So we're pressing up and across and crunching at the same time and rolling onto that opposite side elbow. Now, if you want to do a mixture of the two, you can have your knees bent, and that'll get your abs involved to a certain degree, but not quite as extreme as having your legs out straight. Again, you decide which variation's right for you, making sure to breathe. Whatever you do, do not hold your breath on this one. Good, keep it going. Let's hit this one for 10 more seconds. Stick with it side to side for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We need both dumbbells up on your feet. We have a skier swing next. Feet are shoulder width apart, little bend in our knees, both palms facing one another. Swing those dumbbells back. I'm gonna swing my dumbbells up overhead where Claudia is gonna swing hers out until they're parallel to the ground. But the big thing that both of these moves have in common is you're doing the work with your hips, your lower back, hamstrings. It's not about your arms. They're really just along for the ride. Keep your back nice and straight. Head in a neutral position. Good. Keep it up, guys. Popping those hips. Big power in those hips. Butt back, then butt forward. One right into the next. You're a machine. You got it. Keep a slight bend in those knees throughout. A little bend your elbows too. Don't have your arms locked out. You got it. Keep it up, guys. Let's hit this one for 10 more seconds. Good, good, good. Hit it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All right, we need both dumbbells again. Going to the ground, we're gonna do a combo move, an isometric hip up plus a dumbbell pullover. So we're on our feet, balls are on our feet, we're pressing off of our heels, get our hips up off the ground, back is straight. We're gonna perform a pullover, slight bend in the elbows, pulling over, do not bounce the dumbbells off the ground, and pull back to make the workout harder. One leg is straight and you're balancing on the other. Driving off that heel, using those glutes to keep you up. Don't hyperextend your back or arch your back, but instead focus on driving off that heel, making your hamstrings and glutes do the work.
Absolutely, I'm up here squeezing my glutes at the top of this hip up, just keeping them nice and tight.
Meanwhile, we're performing that pull up, using your, stretching your lats and your chest to pull them back over. Excellent. If you're doing one leg, let's switch. Opposite side. Good. Keep it up, guys. You're doing great so far. Remember, focus on what brought you here. What is it? What's your why? Why are you here? Keep it at the front of your mind, not the back of your mind. If you do this, you can do anything. It's all in your head. One rep into the next. You got it. Good. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. We're turning over. We need these dumbbells. Well, I'm sorry, just one dumbbell for the next one. In a high plank position, we're doing high plank dumbbell transfer. So come up either onto your feet or on your knees, back is straight. We're gonna move this one dumbbell from side to side, or transfer it from side to side. So we're coming up onto one arm. This focus forcing us to stabilize with our abs while we move your weight back and forth. If you want to get creative, you can move it around in different places, make it harder on yourself, so you really have to go and find it. Good. One rep into the next. You guys got it. Get that core tight, back straight, being sure to breathe. Breathe throughout. Don't hold your breath. You should be able to balance a glass of water on your back with how straight it is. Focus on it. Keep it up, guys. One rep into the next. Good. This one's working your core, your legs, shoulders, back. A lot of muscles getting hit on this one. Keep it up. Almost done. Hit 10 more seconds here. Good. How many switches can you get? Let's push that pace for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. On our feet, we need just the one dumbbell again. We're both gonna get into a split stance. I'm gonna drop all the way down, dropping that back knee till it's at a 90. Claudia's gonna drop a quarter of the way down. Now we're gonna do an Arnold press. Palm starts facing us, and then as you press, you twist that palm till it faces forward. Keep that arm nice and close. You're finishing with your bicep by your ear. The opposite arm is out for balance.
And you just hold in this position. Or your legs are going to burn up on this one.
You decide how hard you want to make it by one with the weight you're using, but also by how deep you go into that split squat position. One side at a time. Almost there on this side. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Opposite side now. Right into it. No breaks. You got it. You're a machine. Let's see it. Right here. Whatever you do today, don't stop this video. Don't pause it. You got it. I want you to push through. Keep working. Keep fighting.
Keep that core nice and tight. Bring that belly button in towards that spine and keep pushing that weight up over your head.
Shoulders stay nice and square. You got it, guys. Stay strong here. Stay strong. Almost there. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Good. Okay, we need just the one dumbbell for the next one. We're gonna do a one arm snatch. We're both doing the same move, so adjust your weight accordingly. Feet are shoulder width apart, little bend the knees, hips go back, elbow comes up, and go ahead and flip that dumbbell up and over. So we're getting that momentum and power from our hips, driving those hips forward. And as you do that, you're gonna bring your elbow straight up, and also bring your hand up like you're zipping up a jacket. Just picture that, it's coming straight up. And when that dumbbell reaches its highest point, go ahead and flip the dumbbell over and catch it. This one might take a couple repetitions to get the hang of it. Keep your core tight, back stay straight. And again, the modification on this one is just lighter weight. And if you don't have light enough weight, feel free to pick up a water bottle or something light and go ahead and continue following along. Whatever you do, don't take a break, don't stop. Just keep fighting here with us. Let's switch sides in 3, 2, 1, 0. Opposite side, right into it. Good. Remembering to engage those hips on every rep. So I'm pushing my butt back and then my butt comes forward. It's that simple every time. Hips back, hips forward. Big power. You got it. Come on. Pushing through. You're a powerhouse. Let's get after it. Once you get the hang of it, I want you to pick that pace up. Focusing on what drives you. What is it? Why are you here? Come on. Keep it up. Let's hit this one for 10 more seconds. You got it. You got it. Push for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. We're to the ground, just the one dumbbell again. We're gonna get into a crab position. So feet are kind of close to us, palms are facing forward, fingers are facing forward, and we're gonna come up with that one dumbbell. I'm gonna curl and then press. Claudia is only going to do the curl. You decide which variation is right for you. And that curl, you're just pulling up from the elbow, using that elbow as a hinge. If you're gonna do the press, go and press straight up from that position.
And this is a hammer curl movement as opposed to a regular bicep. You have your palm facing you, you're gonna keep your palm facing in on the hammer curl.
This one engages more of your forearms, a little different part of your bicep. Try your best to keep your core tight.
Keep your shoulders nice and square.
You don't want to be leaning too terribly to one side or the other. Excellent work. Just this awkwardness of this one. It's supposed to feel awkward. Forces your body to stabilize. A lot of muscles working and engaging here. Let's switch sides in 3, 2, 1, 0. Opposite side, switch it up. If you don't have to, don't go down in between. Good. Find that right sweet spot for your hand where it feels better and keep it up. You got it. One into the next. Stay focused, guys. Stay in it rep by rep. Don't let your mind drift off. Be right here. Focus on what you're working towards. What's that goal? What are you after? What are you trying to do to get there every day? Let's go. Come on. Get after it, guys. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Nice. All right, we need both dumbbells for the next one. We're going to hit those legs next. We're going to do either a squat plus shrug and calf raise or a squat plus shrug and jump. You decide which version is right for you. It's biomechanically very similar moves. The only difference is I'm getting speed momentum going and I'm actually jumping at the top. Either way, we're dropping those hips. Weight back in your hips, that is. Keeping those knees out. And on that shrug, you're bringing your shoulders to your ears using those trap muscles. Good, one to the next. It's a tough one, guys. You're not imagining it. We're right here with you, suffering through it with you. That's all right. Think about how good you're gonna feel when it's all said and done. One into the next. Good. Stay focused on this one. Let's hit it for 10 more seconds. Almost there, almost there. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Whew, both dumbbells needed. Let's go to the ground for the next one. We're gonna do a hollow body plus chest press. First thing you're gonna do is bring your chin up off the ground and get your shoulder blades off the ground. Helps keep your back straight. Now, I'm gonna press with my legs out straight. Claudia's gonna do it with her knees bent. Chest press plus hollow body. The straighter your legs are, the harder this one will be. You decide what's right for you. Good. Keep that chin tucked, head up. It'll help you keep your back flat on the ground. You don't want your back to come up and start arching. Good, stay in it, guys. Tough one, I know.
Remembering to breathe. On these types of movements, you definitely, or on every movement, you want to exhale as you're lifting the weights up over your body. So you exhale up and inhale on the way back down.
Staying focused. This one's working your abs, your legs just a little bit, but mostly your chest, shoulders, and your core. Keep it up. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We're up on our feet. Ooh. Let's get those legs going now. I'm gonna do a reaching lunge. Claudia's gonna do a reaching split squat. Difference is I'm gonna step every time, dropping that knee down to a 90 and reach at the same time. Claudia is just go ahead and starting in that split stance position, dropping that back knee to a 90.
Bringing those weights right in front of my shin and right back up.
Like you're reaching for something, like the name reaching lunge or reaching split squat suggests. We're gonna go half and half on each side. Keep it up. We're right there with you. Feel those quads burning? We feel them too, but you're stronger than that burn. Switching sides in 3, 2, 1, 0. Opposite side, right into it. Come on, you got it, guys.
Just dropping that knee straight down.
Your sensation to quit may be strong, but your will is stronger. Keep it up, fight through it. How tough are you? Prove it to yourself today. You got it, one into the next. Staying focused on your grind. Every rep getting you a little bit closer to where you need to be. Good. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Woo. Nice. All right, go ahead and set your weights down. It's a 20-second rest period in total, not very long. So if you want some water, you want to grab a towel, now's the time to do it. We're going hard and fast today. We're going to do one more revolution through.
So that, you know what that means. That means you got to kick it up a notch.
You already know what moves are coming.
So
give it everything you got.
This isn't new.
Yeah, you know the drill. Okay, we need both dumbbells for this first one. We're going dumbbell clean, swinging those dumbbells back, and then either into a front squat or into the reverse lunge. You decide which one of these is right for you. And again, throughout the course of this workout, you need to change up which modification you're doing. Feel free to do so. We encourage you to do so. Remember, fitness is not a one-size-fits-all solution. So you gotta make this your own.
Keep that core nice and tight. Draw that belly button in towards your spine. Keep your head up, chest up into that front squat. Keeping those knees out. Let's pick up that pace a little more.
There it is. What do you got? Put it out there, guys. Not saving anything in that tank. Putting it all on the line today. No regrets on this one. Come on.
You love the way you feel when this workout's all over.
Oh my goodness, yes.
I read your comments all the time. I did it.
That feeling of accomplishment. You got it. Let's hang in there for this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We need just one dumbbell for the next one. We're going to the ground. We're doing that push-up plus twist and press, either from your knees or up top. We go push-up, elbow in, row, turn, and press. Keep that elbow in throughout. Making sure to breathe.
Nice and controlled.
Core stays tight.
Whew.
And if you got to really go a little slower on this one to make sure you use good form, totally cool. Don't want you to sacrifice form, get too sloppy with it. This one requires a lot of balance and stability. A lot of separate parts on this one. And as we get tired, it gets harder to stabilize.
Totally, our coordination is thrown off.
As you can see from ours right now too, we're not perfect either. We're gonna switch sides in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Opposite side, right up and into it. No wasting time on this one. Just keep it moving. And again, you'll notice we're not perfect either. We're just here trying to get better like you guys. One rep at a time. Should just be competing with yourself. That's your competition. Trying to be a little bit better than you were yesterday. What's it gonna take to make that happen? That's what you're doing right here. Putting in the work. So you can see the results. That's it right there. Hard work plus consistency equals success. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We're up on our feet. One dumbbell for the next one. We're gonna go side lunge or side squat plus upright row. You decide which size step is appropriate for you today. Just pull that elbow up nice and high as you reach across. Good.
Again, remembering good form on your squat. And by that, I mean really just keeping your core nice and tight throughout this entire movement. It's one of the best things about these movements is that you're really working your abs without doing a single crunch.
Definitely a compound movement. Your kinetic chains working from your upper body through your core to your legs. All working together. Let's switch sides in 3, 2, 1. Opposite side now. Right into it. Let's go. Come on. What you got? You might find that one side is stronger than the other. That's totally normal. That's why it's a good thing to come back. Repeat this workout. All these unilateral moves.
You might discover that you have muscles that you didn't know you had.
Yes.
You're gonna feel it.
I feel like I'm always discovering that. I've been working out for years. Come on, keep it up, guys. You're doing great.
Woo.
We're right there burning with you. We're all fighting together. We're all hurting. Where you at, HASfit tribe? Let's go. Come on, put it out there. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Good. To the ground. We need just the one dumbbell for the next one. I'm going into a bear plank. Claudia's planking on her knees. We're gonna go renegade row, and then opposite knee up and in. You remember this one? Make sure to breathe throughout. It's a sneaky one. It doesn't start off too tough, but boy, will it ever catch up with you.
Whew. Remember to breathe in the upright plank position.
Slight bend in both elbows. Pull back from that elbow as you row. Anytime we do any rows, we're pulling back like we got a string attached to that elbow. You got it. Let's switch sides in 3, 2, 1, 0. Opposite side and right into it. Come on. You guys are doing great. You're fighting through. You've made it this far and you're going to make it to the end. It's not if you do, it's when you do. Come on.
We want to hear about it when you do.
Yes, let us know in the comments how it went, how much you loved and or hated it at the same time. Sometimes working out is a love-hate relationship, and that's okay as long as you do it. It's the most important part about workouts is doing them. Come on, keep it up. Let's hit this side for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Good. Let's grab that second dumbbell. We're gonna do 1.5 sumo deadlifts. Feet are wide, toes are pointed out. Weight back in the hips, 1.5.
Squeeze the top.
Remember, I'm doing those jumps up at the top. You decide if you wanna get a little extra crazy and get those jumps in or not. It's up to you, but keep moving. Don't pause that video. Don't give up. Don't cheat on yourself. Let's go. It's hurting me too, hurting Claudia. Thousands, maybe millions, doing this at home, all hurting too. We're right there with you. Whatever you do, don't give up. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Good. Okay, we're going to the ground for the next one. Lie down flat on your back. We're gonna do that press onto your elbow. So either legs are out straight, no iso leg raise, or feet are down. But either way, we're gonna press up and across, and we're crunching at the same time.
Woo.
Rolling on to that opposite elbow.
Exhaling on the way up, inhaling on the way down.
And that applies to every movement. You're exhaling on the hardest part, on the push or the pull.
And we're gonna keep reminding you of that because it is so important.
It's so easy to forget too. Come on guys, keep it up, you're doing great. I know we're feeling those abs working too. That's how we know it's working. It's all right, you got it. Hang tough on this one for just 10 more seconds. That's it.
Abs and arms, what an awesome combo.
3, 2, 1, 0, good. All right, let's keep both of them and we're going to our feet. That skier swings next, feet are shoulder width apart. Little bend in the knees, hips back, hips forward. Remember, I'm going overhead. Claudia's just bringing her arms to parallel. You decide which one's more appropriate for you. But remember, this is all in the legs, in the hips, hamstrings, glutes, lower back. It's less about your arms, more about those legs.
Using my hips as a hinge, swinging those arms.
Forward and back.
Definitely feeling it right in my hamstrings.
And if you're not feeling it there, you're probably bending too much in your knees. So less bend in those knees. Notice how we just have a slight bend in our knees and we're keeping that same bend throughout. Good. Hips back, hips forward. You got it. One to the next, everybody.
Like you're trying to reach your bum towards the wall in the back.
Pushing it back. Woo. You're a machine, guys. Let's go. You can't be stopped. Can't be stopped. Let's go. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Both dumbbells needed. We're going to the ground. We're going to get that isometric hip up, driving off our heels along with the dumbbell pullover. I'm going to go one leg. Claudia's going to use two.
And you notice I have my heels pulled in pretty close, or as close as I can get to my bum, and just squeezing my glutes right at the top.
That just helps her to use the right muscles on this one.
You don't want your legs all the way out here. So bring them in as close as you can.
That'll help you to drive off your heels, engage your hamstrings and your glutes. Remember not to bounce those dumbbells off the ground. keep them under control and touch the ground, but don't bounce them. And if you can't get full range of motion on this one, it's all right. Come back, get a little better every time. If you're doing one leg, let's switch into the next. You got it. One rep into the next. You got this, guys. All day, every day. Ooh. This is nothing. Come on.
This is easy.
Those who think they can and those who think they can't are both right. Which one are you? Let's see it. Good. Stay strong. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Excellent. We're going to turn over. We only need one dumbbell for the next one. Moving into those dumbbell high plank transfers. So switch that dumbbell from one side to the next. Reach across. Honestly, there's no right way to do this one. Just get creative. Switch hands and force yourself to challenge and grab that dumbbell from a new place. Out in front of you, behind you, wherever that may be. But don't come down. Keep that back nice and straight and tight.
Don't let that bum rise in the air. Keep it down. Whew.
Keep a slight bend in the elbow of your arm that's on the ground.
Got a runaway dumbbell over here.
It happens. Come on. What you got, guys? What you got? Put it all out there. What'd you come here for? Let's see it right here. Prove it to yourself. Come on. Doing this to improve yourself, day in, day out, defeating the you from yesterday. Let's see it. What you got? Come on. Let's hit this one for 10 more seconds. Right there. One to the next. No giving up. No slowing. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. We're up. One dumbbell is all it takes for the next one. Split stance. I'm dropping all the way down. Claudia's in that quarter squat. Now we're gonna Arnold press straight up. Remember, you decide how difficult you wanna make this by how deep you drop that back knee.
Whew. And we're just gonna smile through this movement.
That's a good little tactic to use. Big old smile on your face. You can actually fool yourself into liking this.
Well, you're gonna be smiling after this workout because it's gonna make you feel amazing.
Let's switch in 3, 2, 1, opposite side.
Whew.
Right into it, come on. What you got, guys?
Focus your eyes on something. If you're having problems keeping balance, find a focal point.
Really helps.
Keep driving that dumbbell up over your head.
This one's hitting your legs, obviously, your core, triceps, shoulders. Multiple muscle groups hit on this one. Let's do this one for 10 more seconds. Stay tough, guys. Stay tough. Come on.
10 seconds. That's it. Now you got 5 seconds.
This is tough, but you're tougher. 3, 2, 1, 0. Good.
Woo!
All right, let's go ahead and switch arms now. We're going to do a one-arm snatch. So feet are shoulder-width apart. A little bend those knees. Hips go back. Elbow up and flip that dumbbell over. Big power on this one. One rep into the next. If you need to lighten the weight, feel free to do so. It is a tough one, especially if you're not used to it. But what I don't want you to do is give up. We're not pausing that video. You didn't make it this far to quit now.
No. Let's keep going.
You need to start using some easier modifications. No big deal, but keep moving. Let's go. You got to slow down a little bit. That's okay too. But fight with us right through to the end.
Definitely. If you can't keep up with our speed because you only have one weight, that's okay. Go at your own pace.
But keep going. That's the important part.
That's right.
Let's make it through. Here it is. Let's switch in 3, 2, 1. Opposite side. No more on that side. Let's go. Come on, guys. We're going to prove today how tough you are. Prove it to yourself.
There is no pause button.
What pause button?
Exactly.
Not an option.
I don't have one.
We don't have it. Come on. Fight with us, guys. Fight with us. Come on, all together now. One in the next. Think about what brought you here today to begin with. What is it? Every rep is getting you that much closer to that goal. Come on. Putting in the work right here. Only thing standing in between you and your goals is the work it's going to take to achieve it. That's why we're here, right here. Hit this side for 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Whew, switching arms.
Keep that one dumbbell. We're going to the ground. Crab positions. We're coming up on that one hand, our feet. We're going to curl plus press or just a curl. Again, you decide which one of these is right for you. Try your best to stay balanced, making sure to breathe one into the next. You got it, guys. You're unstoppable right here.
Nice and controlled on that hammer curl. No swinging that dumbbell up. No flaring that elbow out. Keep your elbow nice and close to your body.
Trying your best, even though it's really hard, I know.
It is hard in this crab position.
To go ahead and not use momentum and to not lean too terribly in one direction, right? Try your best to stay square. Working all those stabilizer muscles on this one. Come on, fighting through with it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Switching sides.
Whew.
Come on. I'm not going down. Let's go.
Oops.
Let's go, Claudia.
You didn't see that.
Let's go at home. It's all right. Not about being perfect. It's just about putting in the work. And that's what we're doing right here. Come on. What you got, guys? Put it all out there. Don't want you to save anything. Don't leave anything in that tank. Just keep moving. Step by step. Each step, each rep. Getting you just that much closer. Let's do it. Let's hit this one for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Both dumbbells for the next one. We're doing that squat plus shrug or squat plus, or jump squat plus shrug. You decide which one's right for you. If you just want to come onto those balls of the feet, or if you want to get airborne and get crazy, you decide which version's right for you, but don't stop moving.
Or if you went crazy in the first round and you're like, you know what? I just want to finish this workout and you got to do my modification, do it. Just keep moving.
Make this workout your own, guys.
Drop the weights if you have to for this round, if you just feel like you can't go any further.
And don't forget that shrug up at the top. Squeezing those back muscles. 10 more seconds on this one, that's it. This one's flying by.
Just 10 seconds.
Just 10, that's it. Just 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. To the ground we go. We need both dumbbells. Hollow body position. Lying down flat on our backs. Go ahead and curl that chin up off the ground. We're pressing. You decide if your legs are straight or bent in that hollow body. Either way, keep pressing, keep moving. Keep that chin up off the ground. Keep your back flat on the ground. And breathe. Come on, guys. Where are you at? Why are you here? Focus on it. Focus on how good you're gonna feel when this is all done. How good you're gonna feel when you finally accomplish that goal.
That's right, and you proved it to yourself.
All that work you put in comes to reality. Not just dreams anymore, but you willed it into existence. That's what you're doing right now. Working it into existence. Let's hit this one for just 10 more seconds. That's it. You can do this all day. Come on, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Up on our feet.
Woo.
Come on, fight with us. We have that reaching lunge or reaching split squat. One into the next. Breathe. You got it. Nice big reach. Drop that back knee down to a 90 degree angle and right back into the next one.
Dropping that knee but keeping good posture. Head up, chest up on this one. It's easy to try to arch your back. Make sure you're standing upright.
Core stays tight. Excellent. All about that form, guys.
Woo.
We're almost there. Don't give up. Keep fighting. When your legs give out, it's time to move with your heart. All heart and soul on this one. That's all it's about right here. How strong are you? Prove it. Let's switch sides in 3, 2, 1. Opposite side right here. Finishing strong. Let's go. Whew.
If you're having trouble balancing, again, find a focal point for those eyes. This is a home stretch.
That's it. Sprint to that finish line. One to the next. You got it. Nothing can stop you. Not even yourself. Come on. Gotta be your biggest cheerleader, not your biggest critic. Pushing yourself, because nobody else can or will do it for you. Come on, 10 more seconds, that's it. Almost there. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. You can set those
drop
down.
Drop those weights. Drop those weights. No, I'm okay. I'll give you guys a virtual high five.
Let's do a little cool down. Come to the ground. Okay, legs are out in front of us. Bear with me, guys. This is real if you didn't notice. Ain't no movie magic up in here.
No.
Okay, so let's do a toe reach. Big reach, good, legs are down. And then bring your arms up and do a scarecrow. Pull your elbows down.
Exhale on the scarecrow.
Reach as far as you can. Arms are up. And pull those elbows back. Nice and controlled. Relaxing, allowing that heart rate to slowly come back down. Getting a little extra mobility work in here along the way. You don't really have to test it on the stretch on this one. We're just trying to loosen everything up. Good. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Good. Okay. Slowly come on up onto our feet for the next
slowly
one.
Slowly, just to not give yourself out a little blackout there.
We're going to stretch out your chest and shoulders next with the arm parallel stretch. Go ahead and place one hand on the wall. The closer you get to that wall, the more of a stretch, intense stretch it's going to be. The further back you stand, the more gentle it is. You decide what's right for you, and if this is still too easy, you can get here and then turn your body in the opposite direction.
Ooh, really gonna feeling that in your shoulders after all those presses.
And we're just gonna hold and breathe. Nothing too fancy on this one. Mm-mm. Stretching it out for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice. Shake it loose. And let's hit that opposite side now. Ooh, I can feel my left one's a little tighter.
Oh, yeah. I'm right there with you.
And that's pretty common to have one side be a little tighter than the other.
Ooh. Well, this is also my sleeping arm. Tend to sleep on my left side.
Definitely something to be aware of.
Yep.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Good. Okay, one last one. We're going to do a quad stretch. You can either do this one with one hand on the wall, one hand on a chair, or just on your own, depending on your balance. We're going to go ahead and grab one foot. You're going to try to pull that foot back to your buttocks. You can use something to help you balance. Or, like Claudia is doing, you just go ahead and do it on your own. You decide which variation is right for you. Just feeling that stretch in the front of your leg and in your quadricep. Hold.
Nice big deep breaths.
Big deep breaths. And rest, opposite side now.
Cooling down after that awesome workout you just did.
Ooh, feeling that heart rate go down. And yes, your balance was definitely better at the start of this workout. It's harder as we get fatigued. So okay, that's how we know it was working.
Mm-hmm.
Let's feel this one stretch for 3, 2, 1, and 0.
Excellent work, everybody.
Good job. Excellent, excellent work out there. Thank you so much for working out with us today. If you like this workout and you've been working out with us for a while, we'd encourage you to please go check out our Patreon page, where you can find out how you can support our mission of keeping these great workouts free.
And if you enjoyed working out with us today, we ask that you please give this workout video a big thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way you never miss a workout from HASfit.
Make sure to check out HASfit.com for hundreds of free workouts, free meal plans, and our free complete fitness programs.
And if you're on any type of social media platform, whether it's Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. Did I miss one?
I don't know. Probably. There's so many, but we are everywhere.
We want to connect with you and we want to hear from you.
Thank you again so much for giving us the privilege of working out with you today. I'm Coach Kozak.
And I'm Claudia.
And we will see you at your next workout.